yesterday two videos that we studied about majoritarianism principle in Sri Lanka and accommodation principle in Belgium. And we also studied about moral reasons, prudential reasons for power sharing. We studied in detail what is a moral reason for power sharing. We studied in detail what is a prudential reason for power sharing. Let us move to the next topic. The topic is the forms of power sharing in a democratic form of government. In a democratic form of government, I explained to you, it's a question of decentralization where the power is distributed among various organs of the government. So let us study in a democratic form of government how the power is shared. In a democratic form of government, power is shared among different organs of the government. Now, let me tell you, organs of the government, you studied in class 8, you studied in class 9, can you recall the organs of the government? Yes. We have three organs of the government, that is legislature, second one executive, third one is judiciary. So, power is shared among the three organs of the government. That is the point number one. Point number two, the power is shared among various levels of government. Now, question of levels of government. When we speak about levels of government, we have three layers of the government, which is called as three tier system of government. We have a national government, we have state government, and we have local self government. So, the power is shared among three layers, or that is called three levels of government. Moving to third one, that is power shared among social groups. Now the power is shared among various social groups. Social groups may be representing particular religious, cultural or any other aspects, but they have a predominant say in the community setup. That is what we are talking, power shared among various social groups. The fourth one we are talking about, the power shared among the political parties, the major key player in a democracy, that is what we are talking about, political parties, and the power shared among pressure groups and social movements. So, power is shared among organs of the government, levels of the government, various social groups, and power is shared among political parties, pressure groups and movements. So these are the layers of power sharing. Yes, let us move to the point number one in detail. You studied in class 8 that in a democratic form of government, we can see three organs of the government. Every organ of the government is specified to do a particular work. In a democratic setup, we can see these three organs. One is legislature, second is executive, third is judiciary. Now, legislature, the work of legislature is to legislate. What do you mean by legislate? Means to make or pass the law. So, legislature is empowered to pass the law which is required for the country. The second one, executive. The word executive also explains the meaning itself, execute. Execute means bring into practice. So law is passed by the legislature, that is legislate. The law passed by the legislature is practice, or it is brought to practice by executive. So its work is to bring into power, that is called execute. Now third important organ of the government we are talking about, judiciary. So, judiciary is the third organ of the government. The main work of judiciary is to check the laws passed by which organ? Yes, the laws passed by the legislature. Now, what is main work of judiciary? Judiciary is examining the laws passed by the legislature. So, in a democratic setup, we can see three organs: legislature, executive, judiciary. To give some examples, in India, legislature means, in central government we are talking, legislature means Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha. It's a legislative organs of the government of India. Executive, starting from President, Vice President, Prime Minister, Council of Ministers and Civil Servant. I repeat, President, Vice President, Prime Minister, Council of Ministers and Civil Servant. That is central government employees. All these are part of executive. Coming to judiciary. Judiciary, we are talking about Supreme Court and High Courts and other lower courts. So, in a democratic form of government, power is shared among legislature, executive and judiciary. So, legislature, executive and judiciary enjoy power in a democratic form of government. Now, each organ of the government functions as checks and balance. What is called checks and balance? If legislature is not working according to the condition laid by the Constitution of India, then definitely judiciary will interfere. That is what we are talking about, checks and balance. So, checks and balance, for example, legislature can pass the law, that is the work of legislature, but the constitutional validity of law, what do you mean by constitutional validity? Constitutional validity means, if legislature passed the law against the constitution, that is violating the rules, if the legislature passed law against the constitutional validity, then judiciary will interfere. So, judiciary will check the laws passed by the legislature. That is what we are talking about. Check and balance. That's called check and balance. Where one organ is working, the second one will check its working by the legislature. Then, now don't think that judiciary checks the executive or judiciary checks the legislature. So, don't think that judiciary is supreme or may turn into autonomous body in India. It's not like that. When we speak about judges in Supreme Court and High Court, these judges, who is the signatory or the final authority to sign the appointment of judge? That is the President of India. President of India is a part of executive. So, executive, that's what we're talking. Judges are appointed by the executive. That means even judiciary also not controlled, but executive have some amount of say over the judiciary. That is what we are talking, checks and balance. Why this checks and balance is very important? Because if there is a checks and balance, every organ will work very cautiously, so that there is minimum chance of error. That is what we are talking about, checks and balance. Okay. Now, the second one we are talking about, we spoke about the different levels of government. Okay, this is a pyramidal structure you can see. And the top of this you can see central government, the second layer you can see state government, and the bottom it's a very huge, the local self government. So in India, we have a single central government. Central government, try to understand, central government always responsible to protect the interest of the country, that is safeguard the nation. What is the work of state government? To take care of the state. That is the work of state government. Administration in the state is the responsibility of state government. Now, to make democracy more successful, reach to common man, reach to even the last citizen of this country, that's why we have local self-government. Local self-government works really in a very, very low level in the panchayat levels, so that the all problems will be solved. So we have three levels of government. Central government protects the national interest. State government takes care of administration of state. Local government takes care of administration of local self-government in India, popularly known as Panchayati Raj. That is called Panchayati Raj. Now the question for you, central government, okay, presently which two political parties got an alliance or coalition form of government and group of parties? So question for you is, which political party is ruling in central government? Okay, which political party is ruling in Karnataka state government? Panchayat Raj Amendment Act was passed. Panchayat Raj Amendment Act was passed in which year? So these three questions you have to answer. Okay? Central government, state government, and local central government. Okay, here it is. Further it is given here. Okay? Union government, central government, state government, local government, and we can have municipalities and panchayat. Panchayat, we have village panchayat, then taluk panchayat, district panchayat. Municipalities, Nagar Sabha. This is a structure of the government of India. Okay. Now, further explanation that government in the various levels. I explained already the interest of national government is to protect the interest of the nation. State government will protect the administration of state or take welfare of the state, and local central government will take care of the local problems. So power is shared among the various levels of the government. This division of power is a clear example for decentralization. So decentralization is generally found in democratic setup. Okay. Move to the next topic, that is political parties, pressure groups and movements. Now don't think in India or in a democratic countries, only organs of the government enjoys the power. Have you read in the newspaper that because of the increase in the price of petrol, a local jatha was arranged in your city and the government was forced to bring down the price? So you may be read or seen in the newspaper or TV and all. Now try to understand which organ influenced the government to change its policy. You all know Medha Patkar. Medha Patkar is very popular activist. Okay. Narmada Bachao Andolan. She does lot of activities to save the environment. So every person who really brings pressure on the government, it may be an organization, it may be a person. If he brings pressure or force on the government, definitely that is called pressure group. So political parties, pressure groups and movements also enjoy the power. Political parties represent different ideologies and social groups. Take for example, in India we have Indian National Congress, Bharatiya Janata Party, JDS, RJD. Every political party is having their own ideologies. And every political party got their own supporters. That is what we are talking about, social group. These supporters of the social groups definitely support the ideologies of the political parties. Second important, coalition form of government is an example. Take for example, if a single party rules in the country, then the party has to take care of ideology of that particular party only. But imagine if more than two political parties join together, that means several ideologies are put together because each party has its own ideology. So this kind of setup is called as coalition politics. In a coalition form of government, definitely various political parties enjoys the power. That is what we are talking about, coalition politics. You studied in Karnataka a few years back, Yediyurappa and Kumaraswamy, coalition form of government. You can see few MPs, few ministers belong to BJP, few ministers belong to JDS. So that means JDS is a political party with a different ideology, BJP is a party with a different ideology. That is what I am saying. In a coalition form of government, you can see different ideology is in the single government because it's a coalition form of government. Third one is various movements definitely bring pressure on the government to change the policy. There are several examples where the movements or the movements are they are mainly responsible to change the policy of the government. If you remember, previous government wanted to introduce a policy in Setu Samudram project. Okay. Setu Samudram project is a project of the government. They wanted to make it's a separate project of the central government. In this project, what happened? The environmentalists definitely they gone against this project. They said that if you go for the Setu Samudram project, the eco diversity of that particular area definitely disturbed. So pressure on the government. So when there is a pressure on the government, the government will definitely think of altering that policy. So like that, you have n number of examples where the pressure groups are responsible for changing the policy of the government. That is what we are talking. Various movements also bring pressure on the government to change the policy of the government. Now try my question for you. Please at least make a list of social activists. Even Anna Hazare was a social activist. Anna Hazare is also a social activist. He is a person who is responsible, and he demanded for introduction of Lokpal Bill. So these are all pressure groups. Okay, finally, we wind up with the chapter. I will sum up the chapter in a nutshell. In this chapter, we studied about majoritarian principle in Sri Lanka, policy of accommodation in Belgium. We also studied about why the power sharing is important. For this, we studied two. One is prudential reasons. Second one is moral reasons for power sharing. We also studied about various types of power sharing, organs of the government, levels of the government, political parties, pressure groups. All these are different levels of the government. We also studied that what are the positive points of power sharing. We have seen in Belgium, that is called Belgian model. So to sum up this chapter, these are the questions for you. Okay, which is the official language of Sri Lanka? You have to get a final answer for this. Official language of Sri Lanka according to Act of 1956. Second, name the liberation movement of Sri Lanka. Yesterday in my earlier slides, one of my classes, I explained this. There was a liberation movement in Sri Lanka. Which is the liberation movement in Sri Lanka? Third, name the capital of Belgium. Name the capital of Belgium. Fourth, explain prudential reasons for power sharing. Explain moral as well as prudentials. So now you have explained prudential reasons for power sharing. Next, mention any five social movements in India. Already 3-4 I explained to you. So explain any five social movements in India. Next, explain the policy of decentralization. Explain the policy of decentralization. Explain to you, centralization means controlling, decentralization is distributing. Explain the policy of decentralization in Indian government. This is your explain. Keep in mind that if you are explaining the decentralization, please bring the points of levels of government. And very important in an interesting activity that in a world map, you have to locate Belgium. Okay. By locating Belgium, make sure you locate the neighboring nations, because neighboring nations definitely influence the political activity of Belgium because of the language which we discussed in detail. So locate Belgium in the world map. The last one, explain moral reason for caution. So explain moral reason for caution. So children, with this, the chapter 1 of democratic politics, part 2, democratic politics part 2, chapter 1, power sharing. Hope you understood power sharing. Try to understand simple concept. Power sharing means sharing the power. This is centralization, is power sharing. Thank you.